Hey folks, I hope everyone is well out there. I'm Dagan from PMTVUK and welcome to another edition of PMT's behind the scenes vlog. I think this is vlog number 5 or something. Over the past 5 or 6 weeks, I've been taking you guys behind the scenes, giving you a backstage pass to the goings-on at PMT, the UK's largest music retailer, during what feels like the UK's 800th lockdown. Just myself, my iPhone, and the amazing Shure MV88 Plus studio condenser microphone for my iPhone. We've been doing some cool unboxings, unsheath it, chatting to the lads.
What a tune! Just keep on moving, guys.
And giving you guys some tone tips. I'm gonna show you guys a little tone tip. How to do an Eddie Van Halen Dimebag Darrell style dive bomb. And this vlog is gonna be no different. We're gonna have some cool unboxings, chat to the lads downstairs, and at the end, I'm gonna teach you guys how to do the perfect pinch harmonic. I get asked all the time how to do pinch harmonics, and there's actually a way you can teach someone that you'll hear at the end. The unboxings are a beautiful new guitar and a very, very nice tasty pedal, probably one of my favorite pedals of all time, while we're getting stocked up, ready to relaunch the store after lockdown. But the first thing I want to show you is this. This thing has blown my mind. It's a fantastic little amplifier from the fine folk at Peavey, if you couldn't tell, and this wasn't even planned. This wasn't even in my video schedule to shoot. It just came through the door and I plugged it in and I was like, holy hell, that is an amazing amplifier. I'm going to fiddle with it. It's the Invective MH. The MH stands for micro head. This is a small 20-watt version of the huge, amazing Invective head by Peavey, an amplifier designed in conjunction with Misha Mansour from Periphery. It's that 120-watt head condensed down. Now, there's a full review on YouTube right now. I think it's released the same time as this vlog, so click the link in the description for that. But here's a quick little overview. Two channels. Clean channel, one gain, two-band EQ, lead channel. That's the preamp gain, that's the post gain, how loud do you want it? 3-band EQ, but these little buttons here are really cool. Channel, built-in noise gate, there's a built-in boost, which is a tube screamer, TS-style boost, and the tight is essentially a crunch channel, so it takes away some of the gain and gives you guys a different tone structure to tighten up that low end. So yeah, this is just a little sample of the Peavey Invective MH. For the full review, with less of me talking and more playing, click the link down below. This is like a little palate cleanser, a little mousse bouche, as it were. Enough of that for a vlog. For the full video, click down below. Seeing as I've got you now, let's just take a moment to appreciate the amazing Kramer Gunstar Voyager, the Tracy Gunn's signature Kramer guitar. There's a full interview with me and Tracy on the channel talking about this amazing guitar. It's just fantastic. Look, there's you. Let's go see what the two Geordie pests are up to downstairs. Well, one of them's a Geordie, one of them's from Yorkshire. Right, there's something I want to ask you actually, if you want to comment down below. We've just recorded a lovely advert. Hello, Jordan, by the way. We've just recorded an advert to show that we're open again. And we stacked the walls here at the back, but it's not by brand, it's kind of just by color and how pretty things are. We kind of want to keep it this way. Usually we do like Gibson, basses, Gretsch, PRS all together, but it looks kind of fun and colorful. And I remember being a kid and coming into guitar stores, it was kind of fun to just wander around and see what's on the walls as opposed to just looking for a specific brand. So I think this is kind of cool. Maybe do an expensive section and a medium section and a beginner's section. I don't know, comment down below what you'd want to see in a guitar store. What do you think? Right, my original plan was to unbox this EVH guitar. I didn't realize it was a case though. I'm guessing, did you know it was a case?
No.
No, so I was going to unbox a nice EVH Stripe Series guitar for you. However, upon closer inspection, it's just a case for one. I'm guessing you guys don't want to see that. I found an alternative guitar to show you guys instead of helping Jordan with shipping today. Very nice, let's open it.
Right.
Can he go on that way? So while he's picking them up in the background, I'm gonna pretend, you can pretend that this is your brand new guitar and this is the experience you get when you unbox your lovely new Fender American Pro 2 Strat. I don't know what color it is though. The label was blocking it. So now with the American guitars, you get these ABS molded cases. Back in the day, you used to get tweed cases or the Tolex leather ones, which looked really nice. but they were just wood, so they didn't protect the guitar all that much. They were quite flimsy and didn't last the test of time. These things will outlive all of us. They're fantastic things. Massive heavy duty latches and everything. You all right?
Yep.
You good?
Yeah, yeah.
Cool.
Heavy duty latch.
Let's heavy duty latch. What color could it be? Oh, it's dark night, I think they call it. Dark night. That's the new for the American Pro 2, is the black to blue sunburst, and it's absolutely beautiful. So I know some specs on this bad lad before I plug it in and show you what it sounds like. A couple of years ago, they changed the American standards to the American Pros. The American Pros lasted a year or two before. That's cool, 75th anniversary. That's not specifically this guitar, like, it's not a special edition guitar, that's just what they have this year. So yeah, what makes the American Pro 2s so different to the American standards and the American Pro 1s? Apologies, I've got a really squeaky seat. The first thing, as soon as you pick it up, besides the amazing colour, you'll notice that there's the little sculpted heel here, so you can get to the 22nd fret, no problem at all. That was only available on the American Ultras, but now they've brought it down to the standards, well, the American Pro 2s, because it's easier to play. The lovely maple neck now has a supernatural finish, which is a beautiful mix between gloss and satin. It's kind of like a, it feels like an oiled fingerboard, but still has a bit of slide to it. It's a beautiful thing. And it also has rolled edges, which is essentially what happens to a guitar when you play it lots, making it feel comfortable in your hand. You kind of only get it on custom shop guitars, but now on the American Pro 2s. Electronically, besides the fact it's got brand new pickups all together with the V Mod 2 pickups, a nice blend of vintage and modern Strat tones, the bottom tone control is also a push-push. Now what this does, when it's out, it activates the neck pickup, so you can have combinations in positions 1 and 2 of the bridge and the neck, or all three pickups together in position 2 with the tone out. It kind of doesn't do anything in positions 3, 4 and 5 because the neck pickup is already active, and in the middle, if you want to activate the neck pickup as well, just go to position 4, but that's enough rambling. I'm playing through an AC15, I should say, and it sounds badass. Kind of feels like an old friend as soon as you pick it up. The kind of guitar that you've had for years and you kind of learned your craft on. With those rolled edges, it just feels great. So this is now the bridge pickup by itself. Push on the tone to activate the neck pickup. Kind of makes it sound like a faux humbucker, almost. It's really cool. You've got to try one of these out for yourself. Once PMT is open again, obviously, after lockdown. Just the bridge. Position 2. All three pickups together. Kind of doesn't give you as thick of a crazy sound as you'd expect. It's more like an out of phase, warm, lovely growl. So that's a little rundown and unboxing of the beautiful Fender American Pro 2 Strat in this new dark night finish. It's magnificent. But away from that, in my studio I have one of my favourite pedals of all time. I love this guy so much. You can make any amp sound like the best amp, or one of the best amps on the planet. Friedman BEOD, and I think you guys might have been distracted by Mona up here. So, the Friedman BEOD. Friedman makes some of the best modified Marshall, I'm just gonna say, modified Marshall amplifiers on the planet. Classic Van Halen tones right there under your fingertips, and you didn't have to spend years crafting your tone like Eddie did. It's awesome. And they released some pedals a few years ago to get that amp sound in a little box, so you can make your Fender Hot Rod Deluxe sound like a $3,500 Friedman. And this is what happens when you get one. You get this lovely Friedman box. Opens up and there's lots of packaging inside, so it doesn't get battered in transit. You get a little velvet bag. It's upside down. Howie. There we go. Epic. This thing is fantastic, but has so much gain in it, it can deter some people as soon as you get one. But there's actually an internal trim pot, so take the back plate off, and you can control how much gain you actually want the max to be. So I think it's kind of 3/4 of the way up now, and in the video you'll see on screen right now, where I've demoed this for a social post on Facebook, the gain is really low down, and that's going into a clean amp as well. So if that's too much for you, open it up and turn that little trim pot down. That's the Friedman BEOD. It's kind of like a plain pedal, but there's a plate on the top with that graphic on. Very cool. What else is in the box? There's a little card telling you how to adjust that internal trim pot. And thank you for choosing our BEOD pedal based on the legendary Friedman BE100. BE stands for brown eye. It was kind of a silly joke until they got really famous, but we can't call it a brown eye. Same with the Pink Taco 20, the little 20 watt amplifier. Bass, treble, volume, gain, presence, tightness. If you want to pause it, have a little read of what you get with a Friedman. It's a lot of cool. And that is an unboxing of a Friedman BEOD. So let's end today's vlog on a high note, a literal high note. Teach you guys how to do pinch harmonics, a little 2-minute tone tip right at the end. Playing with gain obviously helps, the more gain the better really, but no one likes an overly saturated guitar tone because your tone is lost when it's covered in gain, so there's a fine line between gain for pinch harmonics. Billy Gibbons hardly uses any gain and gets loads of them, it's all in the technique. And the first thing you should do is simply play the note that you want to pinch harmonic on. So the best ones for me anyways are the 5th and 7th frets of the A and the D string. So just play them, well, one note at a time, but really hard. And the harder you hit them, your skin will physically, off your thumb, will physically rub against the string just as soon as you've plucked it with the plastic of the pick. Because you're really digging in. And there will be some pinch harmonic style frequencies in there, and those are the frequencies you're going to want to try and pull out of that hard hit note. So yeah, hit the note hard to find the frequencies you're after. And then it's simply a case of just rotating your pick and moving it back in your fingers. That's where I usually have a guitar pick. I usually use a Jazz 3, but this is all I can find right now. Guitar pick, there we go. Play the note, play it hard. Rotate your thumb to find those beautiful pinch harmonics. So in essence, all you've got to do is pick hard, and when you pick really hard, like harder than you usually should, you will find those frequencies, and then you've got to find a way to maneuver your pick and your thumb and your hand by rotating your hand to pull those frequencies out. So the pick hits the string first and then it's quickly followed by your thumb. Don't rest it on. Otherwise it gets choked out. Let it ring. Pick hard, but delicately. If that made any sense at all, that is how I was told to do pinch harmonics, and it's worked for me ever since, so hopefully the guys and gals out there, pick hard and find those frequencies, okay? That was today's lovely little vlog. I hope you guys had fun out there. Another little behind the scenes pass of PMT Newcastle while we're getting restocked, ready to hit the ground running once the UK is out of lockdown again. And you can come in and try things like this Tracy Guns Kramer, like this Peavey Invective, like the American Pro Strat and the Friedman BEOD. We're dying to have you guys back, and we can't wait to see you. And hear some music for a change, other than just Spotify blasting downstairs. It's going to be a lot of fun, so subscribe to PMTVUK if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you next week.